People say time is the great equalizer.
You can't buy more of it. You can't sell any of it. And what you do with it directly affects who you are. Rarely do people or places stand the test of time. But Holy Cross Preparatory Academy, formerly known as Holy Cross High School, whose doors opened in 1957, is tasked with just that. At its peak, the only Catholic school in Burlington County had an enrollment of over 1,000 students, excelling in athletics and academics alike. The 2022 school year will have an enrollment of just over 300, a number which has gone up every year since the Archdiocese stopped funding the school in 2018. Faced with the possibility of closing their doors for good, the alumni of this school generated over $500,000 to keep the school afloat. Just like an ecosystem, the new Preparatory Academy has become a self-sufficient unit, exceeding goals and expectations set forth, and becoming one of the only local private schools with a growing enrollment. Below these empty halls, which will soon have those new students walking to class, there's a group of young men who have already started the school year. The 2022 Holy Cross Lancer football team is hard at work, building back a once-proud football program. With 7 state championships, countless division titles, and even more college and professional players. Just like the school, the team had the bottom fall out of it in 2018. Past teams had the glory, and the teams of the future will thrive, all in part to what these young men are doing today. And that is the price they pay.
We have a lot of good kids that come here. We have people from all over South Jersey that come to the school to play football. So
here, and I don't worry about next year. I worry about right now.
Decent amount of time going up to the end zone. A man there. Great catch for the touchdown. Matt Chambers. And Holy Cross takes the lead with 1:11 to play in the game.
Perfect throw, but what an unbelievable catch.
How you doing?
So I started playing football freshman year, and I was a little nervous about coming out. I was a smaller guy, not much size, so I was worried about getting pushed around. But it was probably one of the greatest decisions of my life, and I have such a passion for it. I want to not only be known as an outstanding player on the field, but also a huge team leader.
I guess I fell in love with it at a young age. I started playing when I was like 5, 6 years old. Just ever since then, I like playing it. It's fun to me. Kind of helps me escape like reality, I guess.
From the outside looking in, there doesn't appear to be any reason to look out for the Lancers this season. But don't tell that to the men inside, who have been preparing to start the new season strong. Just like the school, the team is in desperate need of numbers. But it isn't always about quantity when it comes to building a good team. Quality, having good chemistry, and team culture are just as important.
Typically, types of players that want to be here are just kids that want to be coached up and learn the game of football. Tell people all the time, some people come to me and they're like, well, my son's never played football before, and I tell them that's great. Because then they don't have any bad habits. But just really kids that love the game as much as I love the game, because it really is enjoyable going out on that field every day and coaching up kids that want to learn, who want to get better. That's the type of player I want.
Those players have to put in the work this preseason if they want to turn things around. A chance to prove yourself to your team and coach. That is, for those who aren't prepared.
How do you forget your helmet?
Oh,
you play skills.
Is that your helmet over there?
I'm gonna say
where?
What
the corner.
I'm not a lineman. You'll have to.
Just play in front of Sully.
Or ask coach to play line.
It has a silver mouth. I have to go run back.
You're gonna be able to put your shoulder pads?
No, I'm gonna land.
He said it.
I forgot my helmet.
It's just stopped over here.
You need it.
Oh, you still need a screwdriver. Like, nah, I need to look at someone, dude.
Every practice starts the same. Players line up oldest to youngest and stretch their muscles. An important step for every team, but especially the Lancers. With numbers so low, one injury could be catastrophic. Practice is where you get better, where you make mistakes and ask questions. And while the team is building their knowledge and strength, they are also building their team chemistry during the down times of practice.
Yo, don't listen to nothing JaVel say. Everything he say is a lie.
Everything.
About a bug?
No, everything.
No, just in general, everything comes out of your mouth is a lie.
I got 12 picks last year. 4 years ACO.
He was running a 4 month after ACL tear.
I said, bro, you are not under roster, bro.
He tries.
Yo, Patrick, is it possible to run 4 months after an ACL tear?
Six times.
All right.
No.
That's a no.
Yeah. It's the.
We shook the kids up.
All right, Doug.
Ooh. What do you think it is?
Probably cut yourself.
You got stitches like me.
That big.
They probably gave you somebody else's
stitches. ACL stitches, they go straight up the line.
They go straight right there.
You're all the way over there.
Okay, make a banana split.
All the way over there.
They're late. They're late.
Is that your
son?
Which
one? Oh, my boy!
Christian, do not run through their practice. On the outside.
You got the mouth outside. Saying ready to go.
Ready. All right, men, let's go!
This is somebody.
My bus.
Yo, give me one line of outside receivers. Come on, little hop. One line of outside receivers.
One line, come on, let's go.
Come on, get set.
Here we go.
Explode on that last move.
I mean, last year I was a junior, so there was a couple seniors that were in that leadership role. So I guess now that I'm senior, last was my last year, kind of got to step up and lead, especially now that we are a predominantly younger team. They're looking for someone to lead, so I guess I got to step up and be one of those guys that they look up to and kind of lead the team and hopefully lead them to wins.
The water in the left one is cold.
Yeah, put some cool now.
No, you're not turning your head.
What number you got answer? I'm 65.
I
want to
be
99. Aaron Donald. Yeah,
I'm 65 next year.
Honor my grandma.
62,
Jason Kelsey. Yeah, I'm 65. Keep it up.
Is there a number on
you? Huh? You're a 59 jersey on your practice jersey.
Oh. That doesn't mean anything, right?
Yeah, no. Practice jersey doesn't count.
Back. You understand?
What do you want
all about, huh?
Love me and wins.
I'm gonna work on some shoots a little bit. Starts, cause I need you exactly. I need y'all to get comfortable staying low, comfortable in it, comfortable being uncomfortable. Right? That's what it's all about. Let me see that again.
No, he's being.
Why you gotta keep wrestling, CJ?
That's it, man.
Well, we don't wrestle.
I'm gonna start right
here. Here we go. Cause again, staying low, right? That's the name of the game. Okay. That's all I wanna see. Right here. Set. Go. Right? Drive him out.
Boom, 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 boom. Drive slow, homie.
It's important to get the feel for hitting as a player.
Drive slow, homie.
Football is a physical game. For now, the Lancers just hit each other.
You
but
never
their first scrimmage will be here before you
homie.
Know it.
You need to pump your brakes and drive slow, homie.
Good
homie,
job. Homie. The best one. Pick him up. You good?
The main point of the scrimmage is to find out what players can play, what players took the next step physically to be able to play varsity football. You put some stuff on film and you start to realize, you know, hey, this kid needs more reps, or like maybe, hey, we want to move this kid to a different position because he's not getting the job done there. So the main goal that I try to take out of a scrimmage is to see who I can count on to be a varsity football player.
The first snap against an opponent this year will be the same as the last snap last year. The Rams of Riverside High School, looking for payback. The only thing hotter than the temperature is the tension between these two teams.
Are you not hot?
I just sweat my balls.
I just sweat.
This is going to be like a goal line set, right? So we're thinking run type of situations. Okay, 10 yard line and in.
We can hit
him? Yes. Yes, this is live.
Thank God.
Like real football?
Yes, like real football.
The scrimmage starts at the goal line, where so many games are won and lost. The key to dominating down here is to do your job and don't miss a tackle.
I've been saving my guap, I ain't saving no sad. Put out my Glock, but I picked up a stick. Don't get any hating, shit, don't want some greatest. My people proud, I'm
both defenses look dominant, until quarterback Colin Ambrosius finds Donovan Fay in the back of the end zone.
Okay, we'll look at it on film.
Yeah.
But that was, I sat back there, I basically stared Ryan down. I was trying to get them to move.
Yeah, that's fine. Really,
the main thing is to get the space.
Yeah.
We're still in the green, so just give them like 3 water breaks an hour. Just
yeah,
to
we're
going to
do it. We're going to do it.
Hit, all right, hit, do it well. Hey, lineman, come here. Good. All linemen, come here.
Okay, because it's time for the dogs. It's time for the dogs to come out. It's time for the dog. We're gonna see who the football players are today.
The block Snoop Doggy Dog Monkey at the Doc went solo on that, but it's still the same. Long Beach.
Another long connection from Ambrosius to Fay seemed to be the story of the day. Even when things didn't go their way, the Holy Cross Lancers worked at it and eventually found the right way. It's like that, and as a matter of fact, because I never hesitate to put it on his back. Yeah, so keep out the manuscript. You see that it's a must we drop gangster. What's the name? On defense, the Lancers weren't lenient, not giving a yard. And even when they did, the Rams had to earn it.
It's the bow to the wild, creeping and crawling, yiggy yes yo, then Snoop Doggy Dog in the house like
another outstanding play by Donovan Fay, this time on the other side of the ball, shows how talented he really is. Overall, the scrimmage was a success. New players got their shot. They got to implement the plays the coaches have taught and worked under fire, processing things when times are tough. Tempers rose near the end. A much-needed lesson in keeping your cool.
Not losing our temper, because games are going to get rough. Both sides, the winning side or losing side, we need teams are going to talk. We need to learn how to control ourselves better with the talking, the physical stuff. Just keep it within the play, keep it clean, and have fun.
Awesome.
Yo,
let me tell you something. My goal this year is to have a better season, of course, and to have as many picks as I can get. My goal, aim for 10. 10. Aim for 10. After that, I'm just gonna be the best. We gonna be the best. Cause if I add my part to it, it was fine. We good. You set. Now I gotta take my son to the locker room. I gotta get his papers. I forgot. You know, me as a father,
taking care of my son.
Don't touch me.
You know, I got my physical in, but I was like, ah, you know, money, you know, gotta spread it.
Come on, I gotta go take you to go get your physical.
Yo, stop.